The case for suing Celsius, Terraform Labs. A securities lawyer discusses the duty of care crypto lenders may have for customer deposits and whether UST's founders misled the public. By David Z. Morris, Layer 2, June 24, 2022 at 4:58 p.m. UTB. David Z. Morris, Layer 2, June 24, 2022 at 4:58 p.m. UTB. After a series of apparent collapses, defaults and liquidity crises across protocols like Terra and crypto-affiliated lending platforms and hedge funds, we're seeing the first signs of what is likely to be a wave of legal action from users and investors who lost money. But those cases will require navigating some tricky questions. Because lending protocols in particular have been studiously vague in describing the exact nature of their services, it's not clear what sort of responsibilities these companies have when it comes to depositors' funds. This article is excerpted from the Node, CoinDesk's daily roundup of the most pivotal stories in blockchain and crypto news. You can subscribe to get the full newsletter here. The jury is still out on that, according to Marcelo Diaz-Cortes, a securities litigation lawyer with the Miami-based firm LKLSG. Diaz-Cortes contrasts currently distressed crypto projects with straightforward fraud cases he's helped litigate, such as Argyle Coin, a supposedly diamond-backed token that was in reality a Ponzi scheme. It was a straight fraud, it didn't really exist. That wasn't the case with the most dramatic collapse of recent weeks, the unwinding of the Terra USD algorithmic stablecoin in May. That token's design was so deeply flawed that its demise was easy for. Follow the URL for the full article. For more on this story, visit the news article link.